Hello, my name is Hit Patel. I am currently a third year student in CSE branch at Nirmay University. Today I am going to discuss about bucket shot. So in this video, I am going to discuss about what is bucket shot, its algorithm, what is the proof of correctness, then its application, then its time complexity of the algorithm and some of the variants. And then I will going to illustrate an example. So the bucket shot working is clear. So let us go ahead. So basically, what is bucket shot? Bucket shot is a technique in which the given array elements are divided into several groups that are basically called as buckets. Let us say we are given an array of several elements. For the sake of simplicity, let us take this number of elements is equals to 3. So we have given an array which contains only 3 elements. Let us take this 3 element as 10, 12 and 44. Now these numbers is divided into groups. So let us take an assumption that the array elements range is between 0 to 100. So and let us decide the buckets, how many number of buckets we want to distribute the groups. So let us take a group of 10. So for the 100 elements, for the 10 buckets, there will be range of 0 to 10, and for the next bucket there will be range of 10 to 11 to 19, like this. So according to this example, there are three elements which are 10, 12 and 44. So 10 and 12 will be in the same bucket. So according to this example, there will be buckets will be 10 because the range is 100, 0 to 100, but 100 is exclusive. For the sake of simplicity, we have taken for 100 exclusive because 0 to 9 will be one group, then 10 to 19 will be one group. Likewise, the last group will be 90 to 99. So when we divide these groups, the 10 and 12 come into the second group, which will start from 10 to 19, and the 44th element will come into 40 to 49 range group. So first of all, this technique divides the elements into the buckets. Now the elements inside each bucket will be sorted according to the suitable algorithm, sorting suitable algorithm, like insertion sort or merge sort. Likewise, if we take insertion sort, then the worst time complexity will be order of n square, and merge sort, then that will be n into log n. Now as we know, each bucket has its own range. Like if we take the first bucket, then it has a range of 0 to 9. So in the given array, whatever the value will between 0 to 9 will come to that number that bucket. So each bucket is filled with specific range of elements. Now the buckets which are filled after the each bucket sorting means, for the each bucket, when we will apply insertion sort or merge sort kind of suitable sorting algorithm to sort each individual bucket, then we will gather that buckets according to the order, like 0 to 9 the elements which are in the group of range 0 to 9 will come first, then the next one, and then we merge, and whatever will be the array generated, that will be our final sorted array. So let us move ahead. Now let's understand the algorithm. Here B is the buckets and A is the given array which we have to sort. Now n is the total number of partition, how many number of buckets we want to consider. So basically, let us take n is equals to 10, so there will be 0 to 9, so total 10 buckets. And then m variable represents the length array of the given array. Now let us iterate 0 to n minus 1, which will create n means 10 empty lists for the buckets, 10 empty buckets. Now for the each value of the array, we will iterate to it and then we will use the multiplier factor as n to multiply that value, and then whatever value will be flowed, and then according to whatever be that index of the bucket, we will put that element into that indexed bucket. Suppose the value is, let us say, take the let us these this is for the distributed value, normalized distributed value, which has range into 0 to 1. So let us take example of 0.26 or something like this. So whenever we 0.26 and the total number of buckets is 10, so 10 into 0.26 will be 2.6. then we will take the floor of 2.6, then it will come to the 2, then the 2 will be index of the bucket. So 0.26 will be go to the second index of the bucket. The bucket index starts from 0, so it will be in the third bucket. Likewise, all the elements will be multiplied by that factor, and the floor, we will take that floor, and that element value will be put on that indexed bucket. Now for each bucket, we will sort each individual bucket. For that, for each individual bucket, we will use either insertion sort or merge sort. So, and then after the sorting of each individual buckets, we will concat them according to the order wise. The first will be first bucket. Whenever the whole all the elements are taken from that bucket, then we will go to the next bucket. Now what is the proof of correctness? So whenever we take all the elements in, when we place all the elements into the bucket, then short individual all elements of that bucket. So after when we have to check the correctness of the algorithm, what we'll do, we will take two elements, either that two elements can be from the same bucket or from the different buckets, right? So whenever they will be in the same bucket, the order should be, the small value should come first, and whenever they are in the different buckets, then the which element is smaller should be come above than the higher element in the order wise. Suppose 0.26, then it will be in the second index bucket, and suppose let us take 0.56, so it will be in the fifth index bucket. So the 0.56 should be come below to the 0.26 value. And if we take the same bucket, likewise 0.26 and 0.28, then 0.828 should be come after the 0.26. It should not be like that, 0.28 should come first and then 0.26. It will be wrong. So this how we will check the correctness of this algorithm. And it is we can easily ensure that it works perfectly correct, perfectly fine on. So for the time complexity, the best case time complexity is n plus k. It is linear because here n is for making the buckets, how many number of buckets we want to create, and for here k is for the complexity for sorting elements of the buckets, because the base case complexity occurs when all elements are uniformly distributed and the each bucket has same number of equal size of elements present. Likewise, we have array of 100, and first bucket will contain 10 elements, second bucket contains 9 elements, third bucket contains 8 elements, fourth bucket contains 12 elements. Likewise, the size will be a similar type of, there will not be huge difference. Then it will be the base case complexity, because the sorting of that buckets, individual bucket, will be less. If the all 100 elements are in the range of the same bucket, suppose all elements are in the range of 40 to 49, then all elements will come to the bucket index 4. So the fourth index bucket will be there. All elements are in there. So there will be no elements in other buckets. Only there will be all elements in the fourth index. So there are 100 elements in the fourth index. So for sorting that, the complexity will be very high, order of n square in the worst case, if it is in the reverse order. And average case time complexity is order of n. It is kind of complex, but when we will derive, it comes to the state of like 2 minus 1 upon n. And that is the average operations value for the transformation function. So we can come to the conclusion that the average case complexity is order of n. Now the applications. The main application when we use bucket sort is when the given input range is evenly distributed, uniformly distributed, and it contains, and it all, and we can also use when it contains large set of floating point integers, because we can easily multiply and put into that number of buckets. So, and the second, and there are other application also in the bucket sort in the GPU, is used to find or search the nearest neighbor. Now the variants. In the variants of the bucket sort, there are some generic bucket sort, proxmox sort, then histogram sort, then postman sort, and shuffle sort. The mostly widely used is generic bucket sort. Now let us take an example. Let us say the point 26, which array is shown in the horizontal frame, is the given array which we have to sort. And here we have taken 10 elements, so 10 bucket size. So there will be 0 to 9 index, 10 buckets, and this is the value which has been given to us to sort. Now for the first time, we will iterate from all the arrays. So first, from first to last index value. So here the element, here the bucket size is 10, so n is equals to 10. So when we recall, in the algorithm we have used n into whatever the value, then we will take the floor and that index will pull. So here 10 buckets, so 0.26 into 10 is equals to 2.6, and the floor value will be 2. So we'll put this element in this second index bucket. As here I shows the step where to put the element. So A of 0 will be put to the B of 2. Now for the second element, the algorithm will be same for the all elements. So 0.32 multiplied by 10 is equals to 3.2. when we'll take floor, it will be 3, we'll put to 3. Then same procedure goes. Here it will be the kind of for the for efficiently use, we will the buckets are of the linked list, so we kind of give the links to that the same bucket. If we don't want to use the linked list, we can use the vector, but in the C++, vector are basically kind of linked list type of for the efficient efficient traversal. So the based buckets are kind of linked list. Based bucket structure is linked list. So after the 32, there will be 38 and 35. It is not in the order, because whenever the 38 comes first, so we'll put 38, and then 35 will be comes, then the 35 will be comes. Now this is the our last element, A of 9 to B of 5. 0.53 is multiplied by 10 is equals to 5.3, and the floor value will be 5. So we will put into this category, in this bucket. Now for the each individual bucket, we have to sort. The first we will sort this third index bucket. So I will highlight in the next iteration. So these boxes are highlighted. after which we have sorted. See here, the here the values are 0.38, and then after it 0.35. After the sorting, the 0.35 will come first and 0.38. Now see in the fifth bucket, 0.59 is first and then 0.53. So after sorting the fifth number of the bucket, the 0.53 will come first and then 0.59. Same goes to here. 0.62 will come first and then 0.64 come. So all buckets are sorted because these are the only one elements, and these have none. So there will be no need to sort because the size of that elements will be either 0 or 1. So after this, we will gather all the elements from the bucket into order wise. So we will take first from here, then from all the elements from here, then from here, and then from all elements from here, then we will go to this. So after gathering all the data, the final sorted array will be this: 0.12, 0.26, 0.32, 0.35, 0.38, then 0.53, then 0.59, then 0.62, then 0.64, and then 0.75. Thank you.